June the 6th is the Russian Day, Russian Language Day here at the United Nations. And we have been celebrating it starting with May 31st with this wonderful exhibit here by Olga. And as the event spills over into today, June 7th, as she has so many talents, she will read her poetry to us. And that brings me sweet memories of doing a show, a poetic show, right? That's 12 years ago? Right. Well, just ages ago.
Oh, wow.
On a big stage at the Dag Hammarskjöld Library Auditorium, packed house, about 200 people, and it was a huge success.
Awesome.
So now we are bringing her back in a way.
Yeah, I think you have a very awesome responsibility, you know, because language is the culture of a people and the way to communicate with people. Why I say you have an awesome job is that today, we will talk what's going on internationally, in Russia versus United States and the rest of the world. Having also worked across cultural lines, you know, within the U.S., because she has also worked with all these Spanish people and all that stuff. I think that you may want to share some perspectives given the role of Russia in the world today versus your job and how you want to go forward.
Well, I am a translator at the UN, right? So being the head of the Russian Book Club is, again, another chair I sit on. And that's what we try to do, bring the Russian culture, Russian values to people all over the world to share with. And Olga is a wonderful example, a wonderful specimen of that, representative of that culture to be shared with the others. Her art actually boosts energy, boosts productivity, and kind of puts your head in the right place, puts your thinking in the right place. And that's, I believe, what the world needs now. It's not just the individual people.
Yeah. That's why I'm emphasizing really about how to do it beyond just the shores of this building.
Yes.
Because if you look around, we don't have people from Guatemala here or Mexico and all that, right?
Oh yes, so there are. In this building, yeah, we have.
I know what I'm saying. Is occasionally, you can move to the Bronx. You can go to Brooklyn or go to Staten Island and meet people of different cultures.
I just want to add that whatever I do, my art, my poetry, my science and scientific project, it's all about uniting people together.
Absolutely.
Making them successful, making them happier, making them, you know, greeting and meeting each other and communicating more effectively. I hope one day it will be translated into many languages, so more happy people, you know, will get together and, you know, become happier.
Yeah, art after all is universal language. Right?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.